In this video, let us discuss how to calculate bank reconciliation statement when we have a favorable cash book balance or passbook balance and unfavorable cash book balance or passbook balance. If you watch this video till the end, you will be able to work out the problems without by-hearting anything. So I have taken a few examples and I have worked out answers for you. Before moving on to problems and seeing how to calculate, there are certain things that you have to understand. The first thing is, what is a favorable balance? For a cash book, we will call it as a favorable balance when the receipts are more than the payments. For the passbook, if the deposits are more than the withdrawals, then we call it as a favorable balance. So for a cash book, if we have a debit balance, then it is favorable, and for a passbook, if you have a credit balance, then again it is favorable. And what is an unfavorable balance? Unfavorable balance means if your payments are more than your receipts, or if your withdrawal are more than your deposits, then we call it as unfavorable or overdrawn balance. For a cash book, if it shows a credit balance, then it is unfavorable. And for a passbook, if it shows a debit balance, then it is unfavorable or overdrawn balance. So you all know that for when we are working out cash book, whenever money comes into the business, we will debit it. That is, we will debit all receipts and we will credit all payments. And when you work in the passbook, whenever money is deposited, there will be a credit entry in the passbook, or your passbook will be credited. If you are withdrawing money or if you are taking money, then your passbook will be debited. So these are all a few basic things that you should know. Now, let us see how to work out problems under bank reconciliation statement. I have taken one question, and in this question, we are starting with the bank balance as per cash book. This is a favorable balance. So with the favorable balance, how to work out the answer? Okay, so this I have written it here. This is a favorable cash book balance. CB stands for cash book, PB stands for passbook. And this 1, 2, and 3, what I have given here is the question numbers. This is the second transaction, third transaction, and this is for fourth, and this is for the fifth one. Okay, now let us, the first one is balance as per cash book, with which we will start the answer. The second one is checks issued but not presented for payment. What does it mean? We have given a check to a customer. As soon as we give a check, we make a payment through check. What will we do? We will enter in the cash book and we will record that we have made the payment. So our cash book balance will be low. For that only I have given a minus sign here. Minus sign means the balance is low. And it is not presented for payment. The customer who got our check, he did not present it to the bank for payment. So what will happen? The passbook balance will be high. Plus sign indicates high balance to the extent of 6,000 rupees. That is, when we give a check to the customer, we have given a check to the customer for 6,000 rupees. We will make an entry immediately in the cash book. So our cash book balance will be less to the extent of 6,000. And the passbook, since the customer did not encash the check, our passbook balance will be high to the extent of 6,000 rupees. Okay, moving to the third one. The bank has directly collected dividend and credited to the bank account, not entered in the cash book. So normally the customers will give standing instructions to the bank for collecting dividend, paying rent, receiving interest, paying interest, whatever it is. So as per the standing instructions, the bank has collected dividend of rupees 8,000 and this amount is credited to the bank account. Credited means deposited to the bank account. So that will increase our passbook balance to the extent of 8,000 rupees. Since this amount is not entered in the cash book will be less to the extent of 8,000 rupees. So the cash book balance will be low and the passbook balance will be high. Then the next one is bank charges of rupees 400 was not entered in the cash book. Usually for handling the accounts, the bank will ask for some charges, some payment from the customer. So this bank charges will be taken by the bank directly from the account. So the bank has debited 400 rupees as bank charges and it is not entered in the cash book. Since this is an expense, our passbook balance will be low. The bank has directly taken 400 rupees from the bank account. So our passbook balance will be low. Since this is not recorded in the cash book balance will be high to the extent of this 400 rupees. Okay, the next one is a check for rupees 6000 was deposited but not collected. So what has happened here is we have received a check. One of our customer has given us a check. So as soon as we received the check, what will we do? We will make an entry in the cash book that we have received a payment. If you receive a payment, your balance will increase. So the cash book balance will be high. But we did not, the bank has not encashed the check. Till the date of this reconciliation statement, the bank has not collected the payment for this check. So the passbook balance will be low. Only when the bank, the check is realized, the passbook balance will increase. So the passbook balance will be low. So this plus and minus sign, you should know how to put. If the transaction increases the passbook balance or decreases the passbook balance, or it increases cash book or passbook. That is what you have to analyze. Okay, after this, what we have to do? We are starting with the favorable cash book balance. If you are starting with the favorable cash book balance, you will strike off this cash book column. We will strike off this cash book column and we will work out the answer as per this passbook column. How to work out the answer? So I have taken a particular column and two amount columns. We will start our answer with the balance as per cash book. It is given as the first item. Balance as per cash book, write the amount in the outer column. Then here look at the calculation that we have done here. If it indicates plus sign, you have to add it. If it indicates minus sign, you have to deduct it. So as per this calculation, the second and third transaction should be added and the fourth and fifth transaction should be deducted. So I am adding the second and third. What is the second transaction? Check issued but not presented. See, I have written here check issued but not presented. Then third one is bank has directly collected dividend. Dividend directly collected by bank. The second and transaction, we are writing the amount in the inner column, adding it, bringing it to the outer column, add it from the balance as per cash book, you will get 64,000, writing it in the outer column itself. Now, what are the transactions that we have to deduct? Fourth one and fifth one. Fourth one is bank charges. See, fourth one, bank charges, I have written the amount in the inner column. Then fifth one is check deposited but not collected. See, I have written it here. Check deposited but not collected. Return the amount in the inner column. Add it, bring it to the outer column, deduct it from the previous answer. The answer that you get is balance as per passbook. So this is very simple. By a simple logic, you can do the calculation without by-hearting anything. Now let us see another example with balance as per passbook. So I have taken another question here. The balance, we are going to start working out the answer with the passbook balance. Okay, now as usual, CB stands for cash book and PB stands for passbook. A, B, C, D represents the question number. What is the first transaction? Check paid into bank but not cleared. So we have paid a check. That is, we received check from our customer. As soon as we receive a check, what will we do? We will increase our cash book balance. We will record that we have received money. So our cash book balance will be increased. But it has not yet been cleared by the banker. That is, the check is not yet realized. So the passbook balance will be low for these two transactions, for 1000 rupees and 1500 rupees. Then the next one is bank charges. I already told you, bank charges is an expense which the bank will take directly from our bank account. So when the bank has taken an amount from our bank account, what will happen? Our passbook balance will be low. And since this expense is not recorded in the cash book balance will be high. Then the next is check issued but not presented. We have issued a check, but our customer did not go and encash the check. So as soon as we issue a check, we pay a check, we will record it in the cash book. When we make a payment, our cash book balance will be low. Since the check is not presented for payment, the passbook balance will be high. Then interest entered in the passbook but not entered in the cash book. So an interest amount, we have received an interest, that amount is entered in the passbook. So when an interest income is entered in the passbook, passbook balance will be high. And it has not been recorded in the cash book, so your cash book balance will be low. So after writing this, which one we have to strike off? We have to strike off the passbook. In the previous example, when we started with favorable cash book balance, we striked off cash book. But here we are starting with favorable passbook balance. So we have to strike off passbook. The balance is cash book. We have to work out the answer as per cash book. See how I have recorded. I have started my answer with balance as per passbook. Whatever amount is given in the question, 3000, I have recorded in the outer column. What are the items that I should add as per the cash book? I should add A and B. What is A? Check paid into bank. So check paid into bank, we have paid two checks, one for 1000 and the other for 500. Add it, bring the answer to the inner column. Then we have to add the second transaction. The second transaction is bank charges. I have written bank charges in the particular column. Written the amount in the inner column, adding it, bringing it to the outer column and adding it from the passbook balance. The answer that I get is 4800. Then deduct. What are the items that I have to deduct? We have to deduct the C and D transaction. C is check issued. So check issued but not presented. See here we have two checks, 2500. So adding the amount in the inner column, adding the amount in the particulars column and bringing the amount to the inner column. Then the last one is interest credited in passbook. Interest credited in passbook, writing the amount in the inner column, adding it, bringing it to the outer column, deducting it from the previous value, I will get balance as per cash book, 2200. So here what is the difference is, if you are starting with the favorable cash book balance, strike off cash book. If you are starting with favorable passbook balance, strike off passbook. If the balance is favorable, strike off the same book. Okay, this is for favorable balance. Now, unfavorable balance. I have taken example here. Here we have an overdraft balance as per cash book. So this is an unfavorable cash book balance. Let us see how to work out the answer. The unfavorable cash book balance, the same thing, CB and PB stands for cash book and passbook, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stands for the question number. Bank charges for the above period debited in passbook. So bank charges is an expense. When an expense is debited, your passbook balance will be low and your cash book balance will be high. That is what we have recorded here. Then interest on overdraft for 6 months ending, 380 debited in the passbook. So when we are debiting a passbook, it is an expense. It is a withdrawal. So passbook balance will be low and your cash book balance will be high. Then check issued but not cashed prior to December 31, 2017. We are working out the bank reconciliation statement as on December 31st. So we have issued a check. When we give a check to a customer, we will record it immediately and it will reduce the cash book balance. But since the customer has not presented the check for payment, your passbook balance will be high. Interest on investment collected by the bank and credited in the passbook. So one income is collected by the bank and it is credited. So if you collect an income, what will happen? Your passbook balance will be high. The banker is collecting the income, so the passbook balance will be high. And it is not reflecting in the cash book, so your cash book balance will be low. Then check paid into bank but not cleared before December 31st. As soon as we receive a check from a customer, we will assume that we have received money and we will record it in the cash book as though we received money. So our cash book balance will be high. But the banker will record it only when he receives money, only when the check is realized. Since the check is not realized till 31st December, the passbook balance will be low. Now we are working out problem under unfavorable cash book balance. Which one should we strike off? We should strike off passbook. I hope you remember when we worked out with the favorable cash book balance. Favorable cash book balance, now you have to strike off cash book. Unfavorable cash book balance, strike off the opposite book, passbook. Now this is how we have to record. We have to start our balance with overdraft balance as per cash book. Write the amount. Here it is 10,000, so I am writing the amount in the outer column. And what are the items that we have to add? We have to add the first one, second one, and the last one. So I have added this. First one is bank charges, second one is interest on overdraft, the last one is check paid into bank. See, I have added all the three, brought the answer to the outer column, added it with the overdrawn balance of cash book. I have got one answer. Then what are the items I have to deduct? Third one and fourth one I have to deduct. Third one is check issued and the fourth one is interest on investment. So both the things, check issued and interest on investment, I have written the amount in the inner column, added it, brought the answer to the outer column, deducted from the previous answer. Now I will get my answer, overdraft balance as per cash book. Okay, now I have taken another problem for overdrawn balance as per passbook. See, this one is an example of overdrawn balance as per passbook. So as usual, CB stands for cash book and PB stands for passbook. The first transaction is interest on overdraft. The bank has charged an interest for our overdrawn balance. If the bank is charging interest, it is an expense, it is a payment. So our passbook balance will be low and our cash book balance will be high. On the next one is insurance premium paid by the bank. The bank is making a payment on our behalf. So if bank is making a payment, what will happen? Our passbook balance will be low and our cash book balance will be high. Then check issued but not presented for payment. We have given a check to our customer. When we make payment, what will we do? We will record it in the cash book and it will reduce our balance. We have paid a check to the customer, we will record it, it will reduce our cash book balance. But since the customer did not encash the check, our passbook balance will be high. Then check deposited but not yet cleared. So we have received a check. As soon as we receive a check, we will record it in the cash book and it will increase our cash book balance. Since the check is not yet realized, the passbook balance will be low. And the last one is wrong debit by the bank. So debit means withdrawal. If the bank has given a wrong debit, then our passbook balance will be low and our cash book balance will be high. Okay, now we are recording transaction with an unfavorable passbook balance. If it is unfavorable passbook balance, we have to strike off the cash book column. We have to work out as per the passbook column. So see how I have worked out the answer. I have started my answer with the overdraft balance as per passbook. And only one item we have to add. Look here, we have to add only one item, that is the third one. The third one is check issued but not presented. So check issued but not presented, written the amount in the outer column, added it and found out the answer, 26,500. All the other things we have to deduct. Interest on overdraft, insurance premium, check deposited and wrong debit. All these things, write the amount in the inner column, add it, bring it to the outer column, deduct it from the previous answer. The answer that you get is overdrawn balance as per cash book. So this bank reconciliation statement, actually speaking, is a very simple concept if you understand this plus and minus sign. And the other thing that you have to remember is, if you are starting with the favorable balance, strike off the same book. If you are starting with an unfavorable balance, strike off the opposite book. That's all. Otherwise, this is a very, very simple problem. Hope you understood and found this video useful. Thank you for watching.